Hello, Amanda here. This is a video walking through one of my favorite features in QuickBooks Online, which is the advanced search. Now, I'm in a dummy file because I'm going to use this video as one to reference in the future for people, but so nothing in here is accurate company information, just fake sample information. Now, you might have noticed the magnifying glass in the top right corner, and oftentimes people just try to type something into this search bar. I will tell you, most of the time, you're not going to find what you want. Where you really always want to go is down here where it says advanced search. From here, you can kind of set the parameters that you're searching for. I like to keep all transactions. You can, however, select the type of transaction you want. The first one we're going to demo with has the reference number, but you can change. If you're looking for an amount, I almost always recommend doing line or total. That's going to pull in a variety of transactions that way. Display name would be like customer name or vendor name. Last modified date, line description. That's the actual description line of the transaction. Whereas memo is a whole nother field. So if you're looking at like an invoice, the actual product service item description might say one thing, but the memo on the invoice might say something else. For all of these, you know, we've got a few other different parameters. Oftentimes you're going to be looking for contains and then you enter it in. So for this example, I am wanting to reference and look back for invoice that I know is numbered 1036, invoice 1036. Now I know that I would have entered that invoice number in the invoice number field in QuickBooks, and now I just want to find it real quick. So in that case, that invoice number is going to be the reference number, and I'm going to say contains 1036 and hit search. And here we go. It's pulled up my invoice. Now note here, you can add additional, you know, you can add some additional filters, and we've got some date filters. It usually, if you have a lot of transactions pulling in, it will usually only pull the calendar year. So you can adjust that date. If you're trying to find something that's more in the past, just watch your date filter. And then from here, I can open up this transaction and do with it what I will. Another example is like searching for dollar amount. So say I found a receipt that I spent cash on, but it was a business expense, and I can't quite remember if I entered this one in QuickBooks or not. Probably the fastest way is to do a quick amount. And just in case I maybe didn't put in the right vendor or category, right? I know the amount is gonna be the most likely to pull up the transaction I want. So I'm holding a cash receipt that says I spent $63.15. I'm gonna do amount line or total equals 63.15, hit search. Oh, there it is. So I know I've already entered this transaction in QuickBooks. I'm gonna mark that on my receipt and file it away, so that I don't double enter my transaction, which would be a harder one to catch the error for with reconciling, because it hasn't run through a bank account. So this would be a way just to double check. So hopefully that kind of clarifies some of the search transactions. If you're looking for one that is going to maybe pull in a lot of responses, say if you're looking for like an even $100, let's just see, we've got a few, right? If you're pulling in something that's got a lot of transactions, you can do some editing here as far as maybe I want to see that memo field. That'll help me know which transaction I'm looking for. You can even expand the number of rows, and then you can either print or export if you need to be making notes on something in order to figure out what you're looking at. But definitely do not really ever use this. Type in the search bar. I highly recommend always doing the advanced search feature in QuickBooks Online. Thank you.